Hey guys, welcome, welcome. Cosmic Mystical Goddess back with another video. So this video, guys, is a tutorial on how you guys can make your own Florida water, all right? So you know me, I don't do too much blah, 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 but I'm gonna give you guys a little bit of blah, blah, blah so you kind of understand what we're doing here, okay? So that being said, Florida water is a cologne. It's a spiritual cologne, all right, that you can wear and you can use it on you just like cologne for real, or you can use it when you're doing your rituals, any type of cleansing work or attracting things in positive energy towards you. Florida water is like a number one, numero uno to go to, all right? A lot of spiritualists love to use this and everybody swears by it, okay? So right now we're gonna make one for ourselves. Like I'm making this one because I go through so much of it and I'm tired of purchasing it. Like I do get lazy sometimes and I do buy it, but there are times I do make it. So I'm gonna take you guys along with me since I'm doing it anyways, why not record it for you guys, okay? So here I have a glass mason jar. Really easy to find. You can get them at dollar stores or wherever, okay, that sells mason jars, okay? Even sometimes grocery stores have them, but maybe not this size. But you can use an amber one as well because it's dark and you let it sit for some time. So that will work just as well, but it has to be glass, okay? So that being said, I'm going to add some of my stuff in here. So I'm going to add my ingredients, which are roses. Obviously, I love roses. And roses are great for vibration, like loving vibration, good energy, okay? It's one of the highest vibrating flowers out there. So I'm going to add that to the base of my glass jar. And I'm also going to add some of the rose petals too. And the ones that I have that I added first are from my altar, okay? So I just use that. I'm going to be adding some lavender. And lavender is great for cloaking, okay? If you didn't know. So if you want to be kind of like invisible when you're doing some spiritual working, lavender is a go-to, right? It's great for peace, serenity, calmness, and that good stuff, all right? So that's excellent for your Florida water as well. We do have here some, well, actually let me put in my leaves. I do have some lime leaves, and lime leaves are great for cleansing, okay? They're good for getting rid of negative energies and whatnot, so I'm gonna add some of that in there. We're gonna be adding some bay laurel. You can get the fresh ones or you can use dried ones. So it doesn't really matter if your ingredients are dry or fresh. It doesn't matter for this type of working, okay? It won't go rancid, so that's why it doesn't matter. But you can also put your stuff in a dehydrator if that's what you choose to do or you prefer to do. So bay leaves are really good for wishes. It's good for cleansing as well. It's also good for attracting things towards you as well, okay? So we're gonna add some bay laurel in here. I'm gonna be adding some cinnamon sticks that I crushed up. You can put them in whole, but I like to crush them to activate them, okay? So cinnamon, if you don't know, is really good for money, it's great for speed, it's great for healing, it's protective, it's great for success, and it's also great for victory, okay? So I'm gonna add some of that in here as well. I also have ginger. You can peel it or you can break it off like I do. So I kind of break it so it's open a little bit and have the roots of it exposed, okay? So I'm gonna add those in here, some pieces. And ginger is really good for success, power, and that fire energy, okay? Along with the cinnamon, okay? So I have here also some dried sage. You can use the fresh sage, like I said, as well, that you can find in the grocery store. If you don't have, like, dried sage as well, you can use that as a substitute. It will suffice. So sage is great for cleansing and removing stuff, all right? Basically, it doesn't really bring anything in. It just clears out. Right, but you do have things in here that have the property to attract, so it's okay, it balances it out. If you want, you can add Palo Santo. I don't, but you can. I've seen a lot of people do it, but it doesn't resonate with me, so. But if it does with you, go right ahead, boo-boo, okay? So that being said, I'm gonna add a little bit more of my rose petals in here because it is a flower cologne water, so flowers are a great basis for this, okay? Then I'm gonna add here some Himalayan salt, pink, all right? You can get this at your grocery store. They do sell it. If you don't have it, you can still use sea salt. That will work as well, okay? So Himalayan salt is great for cleansing and dispelling negative energy and negativity. So I'll add a little bit of that in here. Oh, I don't wanna spill it. And then I'm going to be adding red sandalwood. You can add the brown one, but I like the red one, okay? So sandalwood is also great for removing negative energy. It increases opportunity, all right? And it's great for exorcisms as well, and it's very protective. There's so much properties in sandalwood, it's unbelievable. And it's great for blessings, okay? So add some of that. Then we're gonna add some cloves, all right? Cloves are great for protection, and they're great for healing and success. And now we're gonna be adding some pine needles. Pine needles are great for new beginnings, okay? They're great for breakthrough, and they're also great for success, clean slate, right? And that's what you're looking for when you're doing your working anyways. So I'm gonna stick some of that in there. Like that. Then I'm going to be adding some lemon, slices of lemon. I didn't put these in the dehydrator because I didn't have time. Sometimes I do. And lemons are really good for clearing up negativity and bringing in abundance. That's the duality of it, okay? A lot of people don't like using it so much in success workings, but it's great. And Oshun loves these too. All right, so I'm going to add some lemon in here. And some people just cut it out and use the grinds, but like me, I like to cut it and use the fruit too in there. So I'm gonna add about 4 or 5 pieces, I believe. And then I'm gonna be adding some oranges, all right? Oranges are great for success, okay? Oranges are great for prosperity, joy, and that positive vibration, positive energy. All right. Oh, I'm sticking it down. Yikes. Alrighty, and now we're going to be adding some mint. Mint is really good, all right? I like fresh mint. Mint is really good for cleansing away negative energy, welcomes in positive energy, rebirth, and bridges between the life and death, okay? So I'm going to just break it up a little bit because it's kind of large and I need room still. All right, so that's that. I'm gonna add a little bit of more of my petals because I just think it looks so pretty and it's so high vibrational. Why not? Never have enough. All right, because it has the floral scent to it. And then here I have my bell flowers, okay? Bell flowers are very highly revered amongst fairies, okay? So if you like to work with fairy energy in the fays, they love this stuff, okay? It brings good luck, it compels the truth, okay? So it brings the truth out of any situation. So it's great even if you're doing a truth serum, this is a good flower to use. It's also great for, it's high vibrational as well. It brings joy, happiness, and consistency, okay? Within all working areas of your life. So it helps you to be consistent at whatever that you're doing and muscle through and pushing through something, okay? I'm going to be adding here now. I have all my herbs and my flowers and everything in there. That being said, I'm going to get that out of the way. And then I'm going to be bringing in this big bad boy, distilled water. You need to use distilled water, guys, okay? So I'm gonna add that here to my jug and I'm gonna show you what I do with it. Oh, I don't wanna make a mess. Ooh. All right, we'll be using probably a little bit more of this in a minute. So now I'm going to be taking my food coloring to get us that color, okay? So what you're gonna do, you need just a tiny, tiny drop of orange coloring, just like the bottle says, okay? So just a little bit, goes a long way. Yep. So one tiny drop of the orange and then one tiny drop of the blue. And I pray it's not, it doesn't come out a lot. Ooh. All right. And that is that. And then you give it a good swishy, swishy, swishy. All right, it's pretty dark. but it won't stay this dark, okay? That is that. Now I have over here some blossom water, also known as orange blossom, but this one just blossom of flowers, okay? But you can find this in your grocery store too, especially in the like multicultural aisles and stuff. You can find where there's rose water and orange blossom water, they have various types of waters, you can find that, okay? So I'm gonna add some in here. And it smells so good, okay? So I like to kind of add my wet stuff kind of a little bit separate sometimes. That's just how I do it. Then I have rose geranium. I'm going to be adding geranium because it's great for blessings. It's great to cleanse your aura. It dispels demons and doom energy. So if you're feeling like doom and you need to be uplifted, this is some good stuff to use, okay? It's called geranium. So I'm going to add some of that in here. Of the oil. And then where's my other oils? Okay, and rosemary. If you don't have rosemary essential oil, you can use the actual fresh rosemary, okay? So I'm just gonna add some of that to my water. And then I'm gonna add a little bit of lavender as well. Perfection. And then I'm gonna give it a good swirl. Don't worry, you see all the oils in there and bubbling? We're gonna take care of that in just a minute. All right? So now we have one of the key ingredients as well is rubbing alcohol, okay? Isopropyl. You need to use 80% and above. 99% is the best. This one is 95%, the one that I purchased, I believe, because I was too lazy to drive really far to go get another one that has 4 more percentage, okay? So that being said, you can use rubbing alcohol. It needs to be 80% at least, or 99% is better because it has less scent. So it doesn't have that rubbing alcohol scent to it, okay? If you cannot purchase that, you can use vodka, but your vodka has to be at least 80%. And if you don't want to use vodka, then you can use white rum. And Ray and Nephew, it's a Jamaican rum. You can use that one too. And I think it's between 40 or 60% alcohol. But the only difference is you'll use more of the rum and less water, okay? So I'm gonna add this to my jar here. And this is what extracts and brings out the properties in the plants, okay? And the herbs and whatnot. You can even add resins, you can add frankincense, you can just go crazy, all right? I'm gonna add a little bit more. Oh, and it doesn't even smell like alcohol, to be honest with you. It's pretty good. So I'm gonna add some of this in here now. You see, guys, the color? Look at the color. It's looking just like Florida water. If you guys can really see it, but maybe not so good. So I'm gonna top it up. I'm gonna add some more water. And when you strain it, you can add the food coloring because you're going to have to strain it at some point. So I'm going to add that, top it up. Hopefully this should work. There we go. And it smells so, oh my God, I'm like blah, 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 blah. And look, Amber died on me. Sorry, guys. So anywho, I have put everything in here. What I like to do is I personally like to put my stuff, my jar, in a double boiler because I don't really have that much patience. And then I let it steep and sit in the double boiler for at least 15 to 20 minutes. And then I leave it in a cool, dry place for about 7 days, okay? 7 to 9 days, depending on how I feel. But normally, I don't use all of it at one shot anyway, so I do usually have ample left over. But when I want to use it immediately, I let it cool off the same day after boiling it. I charge it, obviously, with a tea light to get it activated. And, or you can do a votive candle, really up to you. And to speed up the process and, you know, give it that extra oomph, okay? Usually what I would like to put on my votive is dragon's blood for the power, okay? So here I have some of the water that I've taken out. As you can see, I didn't want to just have to do it on the camera because it makes too much of a mess. But my oranges and my limes have actually, my not my limes, my lemons have actually kind of got colored. So it's good. It's okay. It's extracting. So what's in here mostly is alcohol. So you're going to put more alcohol than water, right? So you're going to dump your whole entire bottle pretty much and then leave about maybe put like a quarter or maybe a little bit more than a quarter of water. That's fine, okay? Because you can always dilute it because you're not going to have it so much with alcohol. I know Florida water is made mostly with water, mostly with alcohol and just a little bit of water because it smells more like alcohol than anything else. I just don't want to have so much alcohol because it burns, right? So, yeah. Now we're going to just try and get the color, okay? So this is where it gets a little tricky because when it comes out and the longer it sits, the darker it gets, the hue from the actual herbs, right? So I'm going to add it in here in my jug. And you can strain it if you feel like it. I think that should be enough. Maybe that's too much, but anyhow, let me see. I'm going to add a little bit more of my blue food coloring because we want to get it this color and it's like more green, right? So we want it like a turquoise. So I'm just going to add like a drop in here and give it a little swish. And then I'm going to be adding some more water. This is where you got to play around, guys. You got to play around quite a bit. I almost got it. That's the color. And there's the color, right? Mind you, I didn't add any more alcohol. I just added the water. So we're trying to get it almost exact. So bear with me. I hate wasting, but it's okay. Just for the video, I'm showing you guys, okay? It's like chemistry, you know? You gotta play around like a mad scientist, guys, to get it exactly the way you want, all right? So I'm just gonna keep topping up with a little bit more water. This stupid nozzle. This little handle thing gets on my nerve. Let's see. Ooh, I wanna lose that clove. I put too much water. All right. Okay, so I think it looks a lot closer to the color. Look at that, guys. Look at that. I hope they don't get mad at me. You know, I'm just giving away all these secrets. Like, hello, right? So you're going to play with it, and you can keep adding more water or alcohol. Kind of. I really need to clean up my camera. I'm running out of storage. How too many videos? Anyhow, all right, so like I was saying... You have to play around with it like a chemist pretty much to get it ideally the color that you want, you know. And when you make a big batch of it, you do have room to do that. So if the color doesn't matter to you, then you can just get rid of that component. But I love to use color inside or when I'm doing my rituals and stuff, I like to tie it in. And because I'm making Florida water, I want it to be exactly almost as close to the original. Like, I like to replicate it as close as possible. Because that's just me. I'm a little extra like that, right? So, like I said, you just play around with the hues and stuff till you get exactly what you want. I'm going to just stop it right here because I don't feel like going any further. I think I'm okay for now. I probably will play around with it a little bit more when I make a larger batch. But I'm just showing you guys... like a quick tutorial of it, of this aspect of it, okay? Because I still gotta charge my jar here and then work on that stuff and set my candle and do all that thing, all the things I said that I was going to do. So I'm gonna just do that off camera. I just wanted to show you guys how to make the water, the Florida cologne actually, or the water cologne, the spiritual water pretty much, right? So this is my version of the Florida water. I hope you guys really, really liked it. I hope you guys do like, share, and subscribe. And I do have more videos coming for you guys, okay? Also, like I said, I don't know if I mentioned it in the first part of the video because it got cut off, but you can use it in your floor washes. You can use it on your doors. You can wash your doors down with it. You can add it to your bath water, all right? You can use it as a spray. so many other ways that you can use it, okay? Make sure if you are putting it on your skin to just test before, so to make sure you're not allergic to it. And also, do not ingest it, okay? This is not a tincture that you can actually, you know, swallow or ingest at all, okay? I just have to say that as a disclaimer, as a YouTuber or creator, just to cover all bases that you guys are clearly aware. So that being said, I have more videos to come for you guys, and I hope you guys enjoy your Florida water. Oh my God, it smells like almost identical. Bye for now.